Today you will learn how to make horse treats that you can also hide medication and supplements in. This is a really easy recipe and I will give you substitutions along the way. Here are your ingredients, but don't worry, there'll be a link below that will give you full nutrition information as well as those substitutions. You will begin by having oats. You're going to need 7 cups of oats total if you're making your own oat flour. Here I have 4 cups of oats, 320 grams, and I have 1 cup of crushed oats or oat flour, 125 grams. Next, you want to crush up about 12 peppermints. That'll be 1/4 cup or 50 grams. If you don't have peppermints, you can use 1/4 cup of white sugar or 50 grams, and also 1 teaspoon or 5 milliliters of peppermint extract. Pour the crushed peppermints in with the oat flour and just mix it briefly. You can use your hands as long as they're clean or a spoon, whichever one is easiest for you. If you don't have oat flour, just take 3 cups of oats and put it in the blender until it is fine like a powder like this. Next, in a microwave safe bowl, you're going to put in 2 tablespoons or 30 milliliters of molasses, and to that we're going to add in some water, which is 1 1/4 cups or 300 milliliters. If you don't have a microwave, you're going to boil this on the stovetop in a medium saucepan, turn it off the heat, add in 2 cups of oats, and let it sit 5 minutes. Next, we're going to add in 2 cups of oats or 160 grams. And then we're going to stir it briefly and put it in the microwave on high for 2 minutes. And then after the 1 minute mark, if you can, go ahead and give it a quick stir. If any of the oats are up on the sides of the bowl, just scrape it down so that all of it gets saturated. It will look like this in the end. There will be some liquid in the bottom. That's okay. Next, we're going to add in that oat flour and that crushed peppermint or sugar if you didn't have the crushed peppermint. And give it a stir. I like to use the back of a spoon because it's just simpler to get it all together. And I don't recommend using your hands at this point because it will be quite warm. Finally, we're going to add in the remaining 2 cups of oats, 160 grams, and we're going to stir this until you can get a very pliable dough. When it's cooled down slightly and you can touch it, go ahead and start rolling this into about a 2-inch ball or 5 centimeters, and then you can use either your pinky to poke a hole in it for the pills, or you can use the back of the spoon, and I will show you how to do that right now. If you don't have oat flour or access to a blender, you can still make this recipe. Just use regular oats and put in 1/2 cup at a time until you can mold it into any kind of shape that you desire. Now, this is how you make it with the back of a spoon. I actually prefer this way because it's a lot faster and your hands don't get sticky. Once you have them all done, you can keep them in the refrigerator up to a week or freeze them up to 6 months if you put them in a freezer safe bag. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. Visit us at jacksonsjob.com for more. And as always, happy baking.